In this mini lecture, we shall take a look at the C operators and try to understand what is precedence and associativity, which is a very important concept when operators are involved in expressions. So let's first try to understand the last word first. What is an expression? An expression is a combination of variables, constants, operators leading to a single value after it is evaluated. So for example, if I have something like this, 2 into 3 plus 5. So if I do this, this is going to be 6 plus 5, it is going to be equal to 11. So this is an example of an expression because it's got operators, it's got constants. In place of 5, I could have had something like this. I could have had 2 star 3 plus a. So this is an example of an expression, the evaluation of which leads to a single value. The first thing in order to understand the operator table is to be clear with a concept called as precedence and associativity. So let's take a look at some mathematical expressions. So I believe all of you are by now familiar with the mathematical operations plus, minus, multiplication, division, and this stands for mod or the remainder operation. Now, from our high school maths, we know that these three are at the topmost priority, followed by this. Okay, so if you've looked at here, 2 into 3 plus 5, I did 2 into 3 first and then I did 5. I cannot add 3 to 5 and then do the multiplication. The result would have been completely different. So let's try to understand the words precedence and associativity. So suppose I have this expression 2 plus 3 into 5. Now if you see here, multiplication has more precedence than addition. So what I will do is I'll first do 3 into 5. That's what I have done here. Then whatever is the result, which happens to be 15, then that is added with 2, which results in an output of 17. Now there was no problem because the precedence of multiplication is higher than plus. So it was quite simple. So I do multiplication first and then the addition. Take a look at one more. Let's say I've got 6 minus 8 by 2. Again, division has got more precedence than minus. So I'm going to say 6 minus 8 upon 2 first. 8 upon 2 happens to be 4. So 6 minus 4 is 2. So this is an example of how precedence was used to solve a simple arithmetic expression using plus, multiplication, minus, or division. But now suppose if you take a look at the next expression, you have two operators, that is plus and minus, which have the same precedence. Now which should I do first? Should I do 3 minus 1 first or 2 plus 3 first? Here a principle called as associativity comes into picture. If there exist operators with the same precedence, then it tells you how to evaluate the expression, whether from left to right or from right to left. So in this case, since plus and minus have the same precedence, associativity tells me go from left to right. So I do first 2 plus 3, which is 5, and then 5 minus 1 is 4. So this is how the principle of associativity was used to resolve the conflict between plus and minus. Let's take a look at one more example. Suppose I have 2 minus 3 plus 1. Same principle here. Two operators with the same precedence, but the rule breaker or the problem solver is go from left to right. So this will become first 2 minus 3, which happens to be minus 1, and then plus 1, which is equal to 0. So I have left a number of other examples for you to take a look at it. The last one, E, which I'll just try to just summarize is, it is 2 into 3 by 4. A lot of you wrongly assume that division comes before multiplication. No, both have got equal precedence in maths. So here what happens is, since multiplication and division have got equal precedence, so what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to multiply. 2 into 3 happens to be 6. Then the 4 is in the denominator. So when I divide 6 by 4, the answer happens to be, the quotient happens to be 1. This you need to understand is an integer division. In the sense, I am not going to worry about the fractions. So if I take two numbers, if both of them do not have a decimal point, then the result is going to be a full number like this. Alright, so this should help you understand what is precedence and associativity. Now let's simply just do a small walkthrough to the operator table. We are not going to discuss all the operators at this point of time. The reason being, for each of these operators, as and when we encounter their need, I will talk about them. So if you take a look at the very first part of the table, alright, let me just take this out. So you will happen to see it starts with the precedence. This lists which operator has the highest precedence, and then number 2 is lesser than 1, then 3 will be lesser than 2, and so on. So just to give you, the highest precedence is with parenthesis function calls or array subscripting. This dot operator is used in structures, arrow operator is used in structures. This stands for incrementing the value of a variable by 1. So we'll be all clear with what this is at some point of time. This is always going to happen from left to right. Now let's take a look at the continuation of this particular table. All right. And I will show you the next set of operators which have decent priority, which is priority number 2. So in priority number 2, you have again operators which are called as the unary operators. Okay, so here you can take a look at some unary operators. So unary operators means they do not need two variables or two constants. They can just act on a single variable. So this is increment. This is again a decrement. This is simple minus, unary minus. That means if I say minus 2 plus 5, it will do the minus 2 first and then it will add it to 5. So these are all examples of unary operators. Okay, unary minus. Logical not means, suppose something is true, if I say not, it will make it false. Something is false, if I say not, it will make it true. Bitwise is to change the numbers representation in the computer. Suppose something is represented as ones and zeros. We all know that everything in computers is represented as ones and zeros. So what this bitwise not does is it flips the bit. That means it makes ones as zeros and zeros as ones. Typecast. This will come when we're taking a look at certain examples. This is relevant in the pointers. This we have already used in scanf. Size of to find the length of a variable or a particular data type on a given hardware where you are running your C program. These are the normal operations which you are quite familiar with: multiplication, division, and modulus. Modulo simply gives you the remainder and it's indicated by the percentage sign. Now, you're again, I'm sure, very going to be very much familiar with addition, subtraction, and all these operators. This is addition, this is subtraction. What bitwise does is, bitwise, suppose you have some bits. If you do a bitwise left shift, the bits are going to move towards the left. Bitwise right in, the internally the bits will move towards the right. The associativity of all of these is left to right. For now, don't worry about a lot of the operators and the associativity. Once we try to solve the problems, it'll be really clear. These are known as relational operators. This lesser than, equal to, greater than, equal to. They are used, for example, if I want to say is A greater than B, that's when I'll use relational operators. Is A less than or equal to B? That's another example of relational operators. This is used to compare two quantities. I can say is A equal to B? This is the operator used for that. This is used for comparing is X not equal to Y. Then this is the bitwise AND, bitwise XOR, which is going to be followed by the bitwise OR operator. Okay, this is AND, this is XOR. Okay, these are the symbols. This is followed by the bit exclusive OR, followed by the bitwise OR or inclusive OR. So these are all the operators which are used when you are manipulating the individual bits of data in C programming. These are logical operators, these two. Logical. By logical, what you mean is, suppose I want to say if age is greater than 65 as well as gender is female, then what I will say is, I'll ask the question, is age greater than or equal to 65, and I'll use this particular symbol, and gender is equal to, say, female, then the condition is said to be true, else otherwise the condition is said to be false. ternary operator, we're going to have some discussion, so don't bother about this. Now, these are all the operators which are used for assigning the results of the expression. Suppose on the right hand side, I've got some calculations. On the left hand side, if I have a variable, the result of the calculation is going to go to the left hand side. These are all shortcut assignments. Okay, we'll take a look as and when we get there. Then these are all continuation of the assignment operators. The important thing is assignment operators associativity is from right to left, and the lowest precedence is something called as the comma operator. Now, in order to remember them, okay, you will have to use a memory key. I'll give you an idea about the memory key as and when we get into trying to solve certain problems in this. It is really easy to remember this table. You don't have to really mug up or learn by heart everything. As you practice, or as we go through each operators, looking at the expression itself logically, by common sense, you'll be able to say this should happen before, this should happen next. Although some of them can be a little confusing, that's when you'll use the mnemonic or the memory key to remember which has high priority, which has low priority, and so on. In my next lecture, I'm going to start with first talking about the arithmetic operators, that is plus, minus, multiplication, division, and remainder. And from then on, we'll keep jumping to each group of operators as and when we need to do some problem solving.